guys, it's Shelby. Today, I wanted to talk to you guys about how to declutter sustainably. Because if you didn't know, over on mine and Madison's vlog channel, which is like kind of secret because it's quite personal. But over on that channel, we are actually doing the minimalism challenge, or I should say we did do, because I think we are done. We did the minimalism challenge that was started by the minimalists. This year, they're actually calling it the less is now challenge. But either way, it basically means that you declutter an item for every day of the month in January. So for instance, on January 1st, you declutter one thing. On January 31st, you declutter 31 things, and it adds up to being over 500 things. Now, if you've been on this channel for any amount of time, you know that what I personally preach, my personal philosophy with minimalism, is to buy as little things as you can to have the smallest footprint on the environment that you can, because every single thing that we buy has a footprint on the environment, whether it's a water resource, the mining or growing of whatever that item is, the greenhouse gases associated with manufacturing and shipping, and what happens to the item after you're done. The full life cycle of pretty much anything that makes it to you has a huge environmental footprint that you don't see. And that's why I personally always encourage buying as little as you can new. And if you need to get something, you know, you've decided you need something, you should always shop secondhand first. It's the way to have the smallest footprint on the environment when it comes to our purchases. And so my reason for doing this declutter is not because I want to be a minimalist with like the fewest amount of items in my home. Mostly it was just because we've gone a little bit complacent in this space that we live in, because we used to live in a garage apartment, which really limited the amount of things we could buy because there was just simply nowhere to put them. And then we moved into obviously a space that was much bigger than our garage apartment. And it's been a couple years now. So just to keep ourselves in check, we thought we'd try this out. But of course, when you're talking about decluttering, a lot of people think of either A, throwing a lot of shit away because it's how it's been presented a lot in the media, or B, taking it to a donation place. And we're gonna get into why that's not a good solution and why I think of donation essentially the same way I think of recycling. I actually have a whole video I recently did about why recycling is broken, not a solution to our waste crisis. I'll link it right here if you wanna check that out. But I did wanna give a huge thank you to Squarespace for partnering with me on this video. Just a quick thank you to them, because this video would not be possible without them. So if you ever need a website, if you wanna start an online store to maybe sell your own secondhand goodies or the things you're decluttering, or if you just need a domain, make sure you do it with Squarespace. There's a link at the top of the description to get you a little discount. So since decluttering has become such a trend, and obviously I talk about sustainability, let's merge the two and talk about how you can do both. Remember how I was saying that donations are not the solution? I think you should think of donations as a last resort, just as you would think of recycling as a last resort, a step up above the landfill. Same goes for when you're decluttering and sending stuff to just like your general corner thrift store. I would start thinking of that the same way you think of recycling. And this is because the large majority of things that you give to your thrift store do not get sold, and many of them don't even ever make it onto the store floor. When I used to go dumpster diving, if you ever go to like a secondhand store's dumpster, you will understand what I am talking about. It is incredible how much waste there is, and it's not their fault that people are giving them all this stuff and they just A, can't sell it, or B, can't process all of it. It's just there's so much stuff, especially here in the States. Hyperconsumerism is rampant. So the point of this video is not to tell you to get rid of your stuff or to get rid of things that could be used, but more so what to do with something when you have decided it's no longer serving you and you don't want to keep it in your space. We're going to go over all of those. Am I ever going to get started? Is this intro over yet, Shelby? First thing to keep in mind when you're decluttering your home is, can whatever your decluttering be upcycled, reused, or repaired? So I understand that if you're decluttering a lot of stuff, this is going to be like way too much to think of using and reusing and finding a way to repurpose every single thing. That's why we have many other tips to get to. But using what you already have is often the most sustainable option. So if there is a way you can turn something that you already have into something that you will use, always try to utilize that first, upcycling, reusing, and repairing. So my number one tip for decluttering everything sustainably and also making back a little bit of your money would be to try to sell as much as you possibly can. The way to ensure that something that you're getting rid of is actually going to be reused and carry on as a useful item instead of just waste is to give it to someone who wants it and is willing to pay money for it. That is the best way to get rid of something, at least my personal opinion. I know that that can become very overwhelming trying to sell all these belongings, especially if it comes down to like 500 items in a month. So if that becomes too overwhelming and you don't really care about recouping the money, but you just want to be freed of all the stuff, which is kind of what I've done with a lot of things, I'll list them on Facebook for free. So that's one of the things I've done and had a lot of success in the past, is just listing something for free. And especially right now during the pandemic, if it's free, you don't have to talk to anyone, you don't have to get close to anyone, you don't have to handle money. You just give them your address, leave it out on your front porch, they come and pick it up. Very easy. Now, this person is not paying for that item, but they are willing to come and get it from you, which to me says that they are pretty serious about actually using that thing. So there are no buy groups. There, you can literally go to the no buy website and type in your zip code, and it can help you find the closest buy nothing group to you. That's a really great place to get rid of things if it's something you don't want, and you want to give it to someone else who cares about having a low consumption footprint. Really, the key to this is to get local and find the people in your community who you can give something to when you no longer want it, that it will serve them. Also, aside from listing for free on Facebook and no buy groups, you can also give them to your friends or family. So I decluttered quite a bit of skincare that I received in PR. I'm going to be doing a giveaway over on mine and Madison's channel with that. But also, I always let my friends and family go through all that stuff first, because if they will actually use something, that is a really sustainable way to get rid of something and also to give to someone who would appreciate it. Now let's get into more specifics. Another tip that I have is to befriend your local junk man, if you will. This is just my experience. Hopefully it's helpful to you. But if you live in a community that has bulk pickup days, which is basically when everyone in the community can put out things that normally wouldn't fit into their bin, which most of the time, by the way, there are recycling programs for those things, many of which we're going to talk about today. But regardless, if you see the people who drive around the neighborhoods like the week before or like a couple days before bulk pickup, we call those people like the junk men. But really, they have made entire careers out of taking things that people have given away for free and either breaking them down for parts and recycling them for money or reselling them, or they do all sorts of different things. So figure out who in your community does those things, because they're already dedicated to handling things like that, right? A few websites you can also turn to that would be really helpful is, number one, eBay. And I know everyone knows you can sell stuff on eBay, but then the thought of like listing everything and keeping up with it and packaging it and shipping it out, all that, I know it's overwhelming. The tip I wanna give here is eBay actually has local listings. So you can put something on eBay, list it as local pickup only, and people who are looking for those things can see where you are and come and pick it up from you. Some other websites include freecycling.com. So the one here is not super active, but maybe where you live it might be. It's literally similar to like a no buy group, but you just list something that you're giving away. Someone can come and purchase it from you. It's just basically another outlet to list something you no longer want to find someone who actually would. Bunz is also a really great app that's not super active here once again, but in some parts of the US and Canada and even over in Europe, everywhere. And you can trade things on Bunz. I was gonna say sell, but it's more like trading. You can also just list it for, hey, like, come get it. So just another place to list things that you're wanting to get rid of. Next is a swap party, which is a little bit difficult, obviously, during pandemic times. But obviously, I'm looking to non-pandemic times. Hopefully, this video will serve as a resource well into the future. So swap parties, like, you host them or you can have them outside. You can ask a local, like, coffee shop or something if you can host a swap. I really want to do a clothing swap this year. It's one of my goals. But you can swap for all kinds of things and basically just invite people over who have something they want to give and interested in taking something off your hands. Swap parties are a really good solution too. Now for tips for specific items. I hope this is helpful. I put a lot of time into this. So if you would do me a favor and give the video a thumbs up now, I would really appreciate it. And also, if you're new here, subscribe. First up is clothing, because I think it's something that definitely, when you think decluttering, everyone thinks your closet and getting rid of clothes. So how can we do that more sustainably, since we already talked about how donating them is not the best solution? So assuming the clothing you have is not sellable and you're not donating it, what else can you do? And we're going to talk about a little bit about recycling. It's really difficult with recycling textiles, because most of the textiles these days are either synthetic materials or a blend of multiple synthetic materials and cotton. It's really complicated, because the way recycling works is you need to break those things down to their original virgin forms, and it's nearly impossible to do with the way we make clothes right now. So like I say, definitely always check local resources. It's going to be different everywhere you live, but I personally Googled textile recycling in San Antonio and found a few different places where you can recycle textiles here. American Textile Recycling Services is one that's more widely accepted in a few different states, not every state, but here in Texas. Stats on their site site say that about 50% of every pound the company collects is reusable and just like resellable as apparel, while 30% is made into rags, which is a huge thing here in Texas for industry apparently. And then another 20% goes to making insulation, which is used for upholstery and building materials and all that stuff, which is a really great way to be able to recycle textiles. So check for things like that in your local area. A few other places that I found where you can just recycle clothing that is no longer wearable, usable, resellable, etc., is 4Days. Now, this one is not free, but you can pay $10, ship them your clothing, and they do recycle all brands everywhere. That's a really great place to turn. That's just easy, but it's not free, so I wanted to put that in here. Planet Aid is another place where you can ship clothing, and they will not just throw away it if it's not sellable. They do have a recycling system. And TerraCycle also has a box where you can just send out your clothing, but that one is not only $10, it's like really expensive. I don't really understand why TerraCycle is so expensive, but if someone in your area has a drop box where you can go and give clothes, that is something that you can also do. So that happens sometimes, like a thrift store or a local maybe like boutique has a TerraCycle box where you can just come and drop clothing, and you can look that up on TerraCycle's website if there is a drop box near you. And that's a really great option that is more localized to you as well. Then to get more specific, if we're talking about recycling denim, there are a couple places that I found. First is Blue Jeans Go Green, where they basically take denim and they turn it into new materials. I think a lot of it turns into insulation, but that's a great way to be able to recycle material, I think. North Face also has a closed loop system, so they will take back, I think it's any clothing brand. You can just go and drop it off at a North Face location. So this is not super common, but if you have one, they do have a program, which I'll have linked below. I forgot to say that in the beginning. There are gonna be a lot of links below. H&M is definitely last on this list for me of recycling textiles because they're obviously a fast fashion brand, not something I support, but they do have some sort of textile recycling program. I'll leave a link to it below. I've never used it, but it is available if it's something that's more accessible to you. And also check out the Council for Textile Recycling's website. They also have solutions that could be more localized to you, but that's also an option. There are a few different places that take back shoes, I'm sure, but the only one that I was able to find is Nike. So they do have where they take back their own shoes. I'm not sure if they take back other brand shoes. It's called Nike Grind. Basically, they turn shoes into new materials. A great place to send shoes if you no longer can use them. Sticking with apparel, we're talking about frames. So glasses, both plastic and metal frame glasses can be taken to Lens Crafters or Target Optical, and they will send it to onesite.org, where they also recycle those glasses. Formal wear that is still wearable, you can give that to nonprofits. So for instance, catherinescloset.org, donate your formal wear and provide a prom dress for girls who cannot afford to buy one. And bras, this is one that I get asked a lot. What do I do with bras that I can no longer wear? This is a very simple website, bra recycling. They recycle bras into more usable materials. So moving away from textiles a little bit, towels, if you have old towels that are just not really usable anymore, or you're wanting to get new ones, or they are starchy and scratchy and whatever, you just don't want the towels anymore, you can donate them to a local animal shelter. They can always use those. The local animal shelters, I've given to them a couple times, always so appreciative to receive towels. Luggage and backpacks, if they are still usable, a really good solution for this would be to go to a foster care agency, because those kids often are carrying around their clothing and their belongings in trash bags. So to give them a suitcase would be something that would be really nice to be able to do for them. Also the site Give a Kid a Backpack, if you have backpacks that are still usable that you're no longer using, that's a really great place to give it to someone else who would actually need it and use it. If you're decluttering makeup, there are a couple solutions for this. I actually have a whole video about makeup recycling. I'll link it up here, but it's an old video. I cringe when I watch those. But Origins, Aveda, and Kiehl's all have drop-off recycling systems where you can just find a counter where they're located and drop it off. I think that's really great because Origins counters are in a lot of malls in Macy's and stuff like that. So just call ahead. That's what I did last time I needed to use it. Made sure that the person who's working there knows about the system so I don't just show up with this bag of makeup and I'm like,
take this, please.
But yeah, you can bring makeup to any of those stores and they will recycle the packaging for you. And then Wands for Wildlife is somewhere you can donate your mascara tops, like the wands, obviously. And they use it to help clean animals who get themselves into situations caused by freaking humans, like oil spills and stuff like that. So that's a really, really great place. You could collect, you know, a few of them in your home. And then when you have enough that you feel like it's time to ship them off, then you can do that. Similar to makeup, like body care products, it's really great if it's not already used and open to be able to donate it to like a nursing home or a shelter, something like that. And then moving on to old electronics. So I personally didn't even realize that we had 3 MacBooks when we were decluttering that we just held on to for so long because they were unable to turn on. So we weren't able to clear all of our information off of the hard drive. So I didn't know who to give it to. Like, I didn't know where it would be safe for us to do that. And turns out Apple actually has a really great recycling program. If your computer still has any value, they will give you the money. But these MacBooks were old, and like I said, they literally wouldn't even turn on. We did take it to them and they assured us that we didn't have to worry about our information. Considering the computers don't turn on, they would not be resold and they would be able to take care of our personal information for us. In this case, because of the hard drive situation, I didn't want to send it to somewhere that maybe I wouldn't trust as much, so I just stuck with Apple. If you guys have any other recommendations for any of these things, leave them in the comments, of course. I would also recommend checking your city's website because the city of San Antonio's recycling website is actually quite helpful. They didn't have anything specifically on recycling computers, but they did link to resources for all sorts of different things. So definitely check out your city's website. They might have good resources for you. Also, when it comes to tech or old electronics, Best Buy has little receptacles at the beginning of their stores where you can go and drop off things like old hard drives if you're able to clear them, cords that no longer work, or anything like that. And another option for recycling electronics and also CDs is this website I found called Green Disc Recycling. So you can recycle 25 pounds with them for $15. It's just like a mail-in program. It's super simple. Cords, mice, cell phones, printer cartridges, all those sort of things. This is a really great place to just like collect a box and send it in once you have enough. If you have books you want to get rid of, if you have a little free library near you, it's a great place to just go and drop off a few books. People can walk by and take what they need and leave what they don't. You can also donate them to libraries, schools, daycares, all that sort of stuff. Same thing with movies. Libraries will take your movies if they're still in usable condition. Ice packs is something I found a few of. I don't get an ice pack in every one of my imperfect boxes. Sometimes we do get them, and so I found a place to recycle them in Austin called Trashless. This is a brand that's changed their name numerous times. We've been in communication before. So they pick it up curbside, but you can also drop it off to them. They don't have a mail-in program, so it's not really like gonna be helpful for you guys if you don't live in Austin or if you don't visit Austin often, but there might be a solution like that near you. So always, you know, do some searching. Like I said, check your city's local website. Craft and art supplies. We have a secondhand store for specifically craft supplies here in San Antonio and also in Austin. So I always donate my craft supplies or anything that could be seen as a craft supplies to them. But also it's a really great idea to ask any local teachers or daycares. I had a huge box of stuff I didn't want to throw away, but like it wasn't valuable. And so I just listed it, like I said, for free on Facebook. And this woman who was a teacher came and picked it up from me. Yeah, those are a few ideas. Aside from like the arts and craft supplies that we talked about, if we talk about crayons specifically, you can actually donate these as well and they will melt them down and turn them into new crayons. And that's with crazycrayon.com. So check them out if you have crayons that you'd like to have recycled. Home tools or anything left over from a home improvement project, check and see if there is a Habitat for Humanity restore in your area. Habitat for Humanity is a great, great, great resource if you are looking to get rid of any scrap material from your home improvement projects. Also a great place to go when you are doing a home improvement project. I really love Habitat for Humanity. Trophies are a very frustrating part of waste for me, but if you're looking to get rid of any trophies, definitely contact a local trophy shop. Turns out that a lot of times if you ask them, they can reuse some of the materials, they can recycle some of the materials, and they're happy to take back what they can so that they can be reused. So I definitely wanted to recommend that because I had a friend who did that and I thought that was pretty cool. I don't know if this is just my experience. If you don't live in an apartment complex and don't have access to a dumpster, likely you're not doing this, but I know so many people do this. So when you're ready to get rid of a mattress, there are several programs to recycle mattresses, you guys. Actually, when we recycled our mattress, we did have to pay, I think, like $30. Please don't throw away your mattress. It's actually illegal to resell mattresses, used mattresses, in some parts of the country. So make sure if you can't sell your mattress, you are recycling it. Just Google, like literally, mattress recycling near whatever the city is that's closest to you. Likely there is someone that's doing mattress recycling. So please don't just go throw your mattress on your apartment complex's like curb. I hate that. If you have old batteries or old light bulbs, a really great place to be able to take this is called the Batteries Plus Bulbs. That's what it's called. You can also recycle these things at Office Depot, Radio Shack, and you can also use Call to Recycle. If you have old carpet and it's like not resellable, like you can't donate it to Habitat for Humanity Restore, you can look at carpetrecovery.org. They do a lot of help in recycling these materials, actually getting them to be able to be, you know, used in some other way. If you have old pots and pans like I did when I recently got rid of my old toxic nonstick ones, you can actually look and see where a local metal recycling is to you, and then you can take it there and they can recycle those properly. And that's another tip I have, is just drop off recycling in general. So if you don't have recycling for something, even if you don't have recycling for like regular plastics and glass, always look up drop off recyclings near you. Because when I lived in my college town, we didn't have recycling at our apartment complexes. So we always saved our recycling and we would go take it to the drop off locations. This is a really great resource to look up and see if you have it in your local area when you're decluttering. If you have old holiday lights that are just sitting around because you don't know what to do with them because they're not working and you can't repair them, you can definitely recycle them in the appropriate places. Check your city's website, because that's a really useful place to go. And then holidayleds.com have a whole recycling program where you can send them in and they will recycle them properly for you. Another idea I have is to save things for regifting. So if you find something that you want to declutter, but it's still completely useful, you don't feel comfortable donating it, maybe think of someone that you could regift it to on their next birthday, holiday, Valentine's Day, I don't know. Just kind of keep that in the back of your mind as you're decluttering, because you could be getting rid of something that would actually be perfect for someone else. If the things I've already talked about do not fit into what you're looking to declutter properly, I would highly recommend checking out the website Think Outside the Bin. They have solutions to so many things. So if I didn't say something that you're still looking for, check them out. Or Earth 911, they have a lot of information and a lot of resources over there that could be really helpful in your decluttering process. I hope all of this helped you. I hope you found a way to get rid of something that you no longer want to keep in your home. I hope this helped in decluttering sustainably. If you did like this video, like I said, please give it a thumbs up. This is one of the ones that I think could be helpful to share. I don't say that often, but if you want to share it, go for it, because I know decluttering is a big thing during this time of the year. And I want to give another huge thank you to Squarespace for making videos like this possible to get this information out to you. So let's talk a little bit more about them. Like I said, Squarespace is an all-in-one platform, so you can look to them to build an online store, website, or even just if you need to purchase a domain. Squarespace makes setting up a website super easy because you don't need to learn coding. They already have some beautiful templates over there that you can customize to be exactly what you're looking for. Squarespace makes it easy to connect your social media and to also take advantage of their blogging tools. You can do email campaigns through Squarespace because it is an all-in-one platform, like I mentioned. With their 24-hour customer service and traffic insight tools, it makes it the easiest way to build a website on the internet today. So when you're ready to launch, head over to squarespace.com/shellbizzle for 10% off of your first purchase.